How many harrowing tales have you heard about people who've survived COVID-19 or those who've lost the battle? Most people now have a story to tell, either their own or of a friend or of a friend of a friend. From the teacher in Nakuru who has tested positive 3 times since September, currently preparing for a 4th test, she has spent 25,000 shillings so far, to a family of 3 who spent a whopping 750,000 on COVID-19 testing and hospital care. Mind you, they were not even in intensive care. I'm sure you've heard of similar stories too. And not just at this time of a pandemic, but even before. I'm sure you've been involved in one WhatsApp group or another, raising funds for a sick relative, friend, colleague, to get treatment at a more advanced facility in Nairobi or even abroad in places like India. Now, we heard this week of doctors too, trying to raise 300,000 shillings for just one dose of a drug for their colleague, to the endless search for an ICU bed, forcing a sick doctor to be moved from Eldoret to Nakuru while waiting for space in the ICU in Nairobi, to the search for air evacuation, whose cost at 600,000 shillings for that short flight to Nairobi was sadly out of reach for the family. And speaking of choppers, MPs found themselves in a similar situation following the death of one of their own who moved from one healthcare facility to the next at a time of emergency. Suddenly, the legislators walked in our shoes, prompting Kwanza MP Ferdinand Wanyonyi to request a helicopter on standby to evacuate MPs to a well-equipped hospital in case of an emergency. This helicopter, according to him, should be accessible through a simple hotline. But that was not the only interesting thing to happen in the House, ladies and gentlemen. You see, after hearing sad tales of doctors working in tough conditions with no medical cover, Honorable Nikal wept, moved to tears by the shockingly sad stories. I'm glad he was moved, because these are the tears Kenyans cry every day, from doctors to their families and to all other Kenyans who have placed their faith in the government and in the MPs they so dutifully line up to vote for every 5 years, to pass laws, approve budgets, and hold their government to account, only to be failed by that very system. I'm glad that he wept, just like the many Kenyans who are one illness away from sheer poverty. I'm glad he wept, just like the many Kenyans who forgo luxury to contribute to one fundraiser after the next for loved ones who cannot afford healthcare in this country or who have to make the impossible choice between the next meal and the next dose of a life-saving drug. I am glad he wept, just like the many doctors who have to reuse PPEs for up to 3 days. For the doctors who contract COVID-19, pay for their own treatment and care, and go back to work upon recovery. I am glad he wept while appealing to the president to listen to the plight of doctors, being one himself. You know what? I'm also glad that he has now dried his eyes, because lest we forget, he was at one time the director for medical services in Kenya and knows too well the issues the doctors were raising. They arise from decades of neglect of their issues and of the healthcare sector in general. I'm sure he's familiar with the Abuja Declaration of 2001, a pledge to allocate 15% of the annual budget to healthcare, a declaration Kenya signed up to. You know, I'm also glad that MP Ferdinand Wanyonyi raised the issue of air evacuation for MPs. And I'm glad tonight to inform him that what we need is to ensure that all hospitals are well equipped to handle any emergency across the country. I'm also happy to inform the esteemed Member of Parliament that we have a hotline in place, the 719, and that we would be glad if he could check upon it once in a while to see if it works, if anyone answers the call, and what help and any advice that they offer to those in need of help during this pandemic. I'm also glad to inform the MP of his job, which would be to summon the Cabinet Secretary in charge of health to answer any queries he may have about the hotline. I'm glad to inform MP Wanyonyi that it is his job to seek to ask about the state of the hospitals that the late Murunga went to, which were reportedly incapable of handling his emergency, rather than seeking privileges for MPs only. I'm also glad to inform him that he speaks not for MPs, but for the people of Kwanzaa and for the people of Kenya as part of the wider National Assembly. I'm glad to inform him that his request is insensitive to the people of Kenya who dutifully pay their taxes and his salary. When all is said and done, and when they have cried their eyes out, like we do every day, and when they are done requesting for special privileges, I'm glad to inform them that they will have to answer to us, the people.